She is the Logie Award winning actress who lit up our screens in McLeod's Daughters, the movie Flirting, A Country Practice and Brides of Christ, acting alongside a young Russell Crowe. Let's look back at everyone's favourite troubled teen, Rosemary.
Cockroaches. I know more than every single one of them.
I thought you were supposed to be in love with Dominic.
I am.
Okay. What is wrong with you, Rosemary? What if you do fail? Don't you want to do anything?
I don't know, right? It's always better right for you. You've always known bloody everything.
You can tell Pruneface I do know what I want to do. I want to screw Mick Jagger.
Kim joins us now from Los Angeles to tell us what she's been up to. It's so good to see you. How are you?
Oh, Ange, what are you doing to me, starting with those clips that are going to make my mascara run?
Do you know, you won the Best Newcomer Logie for that role in Brides of Christ, but it's enjoying a real resurgence at the moment because it's up on the streaming services now and some people who hadn't seen it before are discovering it, and it's all over social media. Is it a bit of a surprise that people are talking about it a lot again?
Well, I'm thrilled that the option is there for a new generation of people to discover that show. It's still one of my very favourite shows. I watched it only a few years ago and I felt that it stood the stand of time so well. And, you know, it's such a powerful story. Everyone that was a part of that was so invested in it. And, yeah, I'm thrilled that another generation is getting to discover it.
Yeah, I watched it again earlier during lockdown and it is phenomenal and you are all so sensational in it. But, of course, you were all over our screens. You played much-loved Darcy in the hugely popular Aussie drama A Country Practice. Do you remember back then, so twice a week at 7:30, there was an hour of primetime Aussie drama every week for about, 48 weeks a year. Do you think we'll ever see that again?
You know, I think there are pros and cons to what's changed in the world of television. I think it's really important that we maintain a high quota for Australian drama. We have such a rich culture and so many great stories, and it's important to ensure that they keep getting told. On the flip side of that, I think streaming has brought a wealth of opportunity. I mean, for me, as someone who's living in America, I get to see so many more Australian shows streaming in the States and other parts of the world that I've had my friends tell me about than we ever had the possibility of before. So I think that's a big plus. But I do think it's really important that we keep those drama quotas up.
Look at you and Matt Day there. Oh, I've got to tell you what, it's making my mascara run too. Yeah, you babies, absolutely. You moved to LA to study with Shakespeare and company, but you also ended up moving into fashion, launching Aussie fashion label Leona Edmiston in the US. Do you still love a bold print?
I will always love a bold print and I will always love a Leona frock.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, there you go. That combines both of them.
Now, we also know you are a dog person. You have a gorgeous four-legged child called Mickey Blue, I think. But you've also been involved with animal charity, Remembering Wildlife, for the last 5 years. Tell us about that.
That was a chance meeting that I had with this incredible woman, Margot Raggett, who is the founder and creator of the Remembering Wildlife charity book series. And its goal was to create the most beautiful coffee table book of all time of the species that it focuses on each year, which is an endangered species. And sadly, we will not run out of subjects. But when we met, oh, there he is.
Look at him. That's Mickey Blue.
That was Mickey Blue. So we started talking and she was keen to evolve their viral campaign. And my husband and I, Sean, we had traveled with my parents to Africa 7 or 8 years ago and just been so kind of shook to our core by the beauty of the animals there and what's happening to them and the challenges that they face. So it just felt like this perfect simpatico and we put our shoulder behind helping her really grow the viral campaign. And that's been kind of our passion project for the last 5 years. And actually our new book, which is African Wild Dogs, is launching on November 4th, our viral campaign. And it's been incredible, the amount of celebrities who've rallied around posting photos with the books, raising the awareness. So far, we've raised $1.5 million, which we've distributed to about 52 projects in 24 countries. It makes a huge difference. But equally important, and maybe even more, is that collective consciousness that gets changed when some of the people, like the people that you just saw in those shots, get behind it. And even if people aren't buying a book, to make them aware of what's really changing. Because if we don't do something soon, it is going to be too late.
Wow, you've achieved so much in a short period of time. That's extraordinary. Any more acting projects coming up you can tell us about?
I can. Ironically, after the last almost 2 years that we've all been through, and in Los Angeles, we were at home for 14 months. And pretty much the only time I left the house, besides going with Mickey Blue and my husband for a walk, was I ended up shooting 3 films while we were in lockdown. So, that one, that's called Wrong Reasons. And that's actually a script I'm super excited about. That was Matt Passmore in that photo with me. It's an American indie film executive produced by Kevin Smith from Chasing Amy and Clerks, that kind of fame. And the director is his protege. Writer and director, and the lead actress is an Aussie actress called Liv Rouche, and I play her mum. It's a really interesting story about the perils of fame and the price that has to be paid for it sometimes, and you know, the long road, the long distance between compassion and people who are more self-interested. And I have to say, my mother character lies more on the self-interested side.
She sounds like a great character to play. Yeah, she sounds like
a great
character to play. It's been so great to catch up with you, Kim. We will look out for those new productions, and we'll look out for those wildlife books, particularly that Cheetahs one. Looks like a good one to buy, I reckon.
It was beautiful. And I'm going to be home soon. I'm so thrilled that now we can come back without quarantine, and I'm dying to see my parents and my friends. I'll make dairy. It's been too long.
It'll be good to have you home. Come in and see us here at the show. We'd love to see you in the flesh. Love. Take good care.
Thanks, Ange.